Today, we're taking a look at seven of Australia's massive infrastructure projects currently under construction. From tunnels, bridges, and transport projects to dams and energy storage, let's take a look at what Australia is spending our money on. I'm Mel Pikos, and today we're talking tactics. Before we start, due to cost blowouts, changes to plans, and differing numbers reported by different outlets, some of the stated costs might be different to what you've personally seen reported or announced. We've done our best to find accurate costs for each of these projects, but if they are inaccurate, please let us know in the comments and we'll try and rectify them in future videos. Now, this isn't a list of Australia's most expensive projects, just some of the big ones. Before we get stuck in, here are a few projects that we won't look at in detail today, but we might focus on in a future video. Let us know in the comments if you're keen to hear what they're about and how they'll affect you. The Bruce Highway Upgrade, Queensland, $8.5 billion. The Pacific Highway Upgrade, New South Wales, $15 billion. The Western Sydney Infrastructure Plan, New South Wales, $4.4 billion. The North East Link Road Project, Victoria, $16 billion. The M80 Ring Road Upgrade, $2.3 billion. The Gold Coast Light Rail Stage 3, $2.7 billion. The North-South Corridor, South Australia, $14.5 billion. Project Sea Dragon, Northern Territory, $1.5 billion. Now, let's take a closer look at some of Australia's biggest infrastructure projects currently under construction. Inland Rail, estimated cost, $9.3 billion. Our first project takes us on a journey from Melbourne all the way to Brisbane on the Inland Rail. This colossal undertaking is a 1,600 kilometre freight rail network that will connect the east coast of Australia via regional Victoria, New South Wales and Queensland. Its stated goal is to help us keep pace with the increasing freight demands of Australia's growing population. The track will enable the use of double stacked 1,800 metre long trains at a maximum speed of 115 kilometres per hour, allowing for the transit of massive freight volumes. Each train could carry the equivalent freight volume of 110 B double trucks. Essentially, it aims to improve national freight and supply chain capabilities by connecting existing routes through rail, road and ports. It will have the added benefit of reducing road congestion, enhancing safety and decreasing carbon emissions with 200,000 fewer trucks on our roads every year once it's complete. Inland Rail is estimated to be operational in 2027. The Western Sydney Airport, estimated cost $5.3 billion. The Western Sydney Airport project is a significant infrastructure initiative aimed at addressing the increasing demand for air travel and fostering economic growth in the greater Sydney region. With an estimated cost of $5.3 billion, the new airport project will be a modern facility with a focus on sustainability and innovation and built to accommodate 10 million passengers from day one. It will accommodate both domestic and international flights, increasing the airspace capacity for Sydney, which will mean more passengers and freight services and less congestion. Western Sydney International Airport is set to begin services in late 2026. Melbourne Metro Tunnel, estimated cost $11 billion. The Melbourne Metro Tunnel will create a new end-to-end rail line from Sunbury in the west to Cranbourne, Pakenham in the southeast with bigger and more modern trains and five new stations. It will feature twin 9-kilometre rail tunnels from Kensington to South Yarra and five new underground stations at Arden, Parkville, State Library, Town Hall and Anzac. It will also enhance connectivity from the existing transport network by including pedestrian links to significant stations such as Flinders Street and Melbourne Central, plus the city's first train-tram interchange at Anzac Station on St Kilda Road. The project is a significant undertaking with an estimated cost of $11 billion and is aimed at transforming Melbourne's public transport system, alleviating congestion on the roads and improving the efficiency of the rail network. It's expected to open in 2025. Cross River Rail, estimated cost $7 billion. Similar to the Melbourne Metro Tunnel, the Cross River Rail project in Brisbane is a new rail line in the city aimed at addressing rail network bottlenecks and enhancing public transport in the region. It involves the construction of a second rail line river crossing in the CBD with twin tunnels under the Brisbane River and four new underground stations at Boggo Road, Woolloongabba, Albert Street and Roma Street. With an estimated cost of $7 billion, the Cross River Rail project aims to enhance the efficiency and reliability of public transportation, providing commuters with faster and more convenient travel options. Commuters are expected to be riding the Cross River Rail in early 2026. Metronet, estimated cost $10 billion. Metronet is a significant public transportation initiative in Perth, Western Australia. The project includes approximately 72 kilometres of new passenger rail lines and 23 new stations, and will turn more than 8,000 hectares of land around those new stations into desirable places to live, work and play. Major works on the project include the Byford Rail Extension, the Forestfield Airport Link, the Morley-Ellenbrook Line, 246 locally manufactured C-Series rail cars, plus a manufacturing facility for those. The recent Western Australian budget saw the total cost of Metronet at $10.5 billion. The project places emphasis on creating sustainable and vibrant communities around the new rail stations and aims to stimulate economic growth, enhance accessibility, and improve the overall livability in Perth. Snowy Hydro 2.0, estimated cost $10 billion. Snowy Hydro 2.0 is an expansion of the Snowy Mountains hydroelectric scheme, which has already been providing energy to Australia for over 70 years. The Snowy 2.0 projects will link two existing dams through a 27-kilometre underground tunnel and power station in order to better generate and then store energy. When electricity is in demand, water will flow down freely from the higher altitude reservoir, Tantangara Dam, down through the tunnel, turning the turbines and generating electricity for the public. That water ends up in the lower altitude reservoir, Talbingo Dam. Then, when electricity is in surplus, lower in demand, and therefore cheaper, the water will be pumped back up to the higher altitude dam, storing all that energy within the water until it is needed. It will also maximise the efficiency of renewables such as solar and wind energy by using it to pump the water back up into the upper storage reservoir. But the project involves complex engineering and tunnelling works to connect the two reservoirs and create the necessary infrastructure for the pumped hydro storage system. And this has seen the budget blow out from an estimated $5.9 billion in 2017 to about $12 billion. It aims to be completed by the end of 2028. Westgate Tunnel, estimated cost $10.2 billion. The Westgate Tunnel project is a major infrastructure initiative in Melbourne, Australia, aimed at addressing congestion and improving connectivity in the western part of the city. This project involves the construction of a new 4-kilometre toll road linking the Westgate Freeway at Yarraville with the Port of Melbourne and CityLink at Docklands via twin tunnels beneath the Maribyrnong River, as well as a bridge and elevated road section. The project also includes the construction of new and upgraded cycling and pedestrian paths, as well as additional lanes on the Westgate Freeway. These enhancements aim to create a more integrated and sustainable transport network, accommodating the needs of both motorists and active commuters. Melbourne Airport Rail Link, estimated cost $10 billion. The Melbourne Airport Rail Link project is an initiative to establish a dedicated rail connection between Melbourne's CBD and Tullamarine Airport. The primary objectives of this project is to provide a more efficient and convenient transportation option for passengers travelling to and from the airport. The new line will provide a direct connection to the airport from more than 30 stations across Melbourne, with only one change for passengers from most of the other stations in Victoria. The project will also include an upgraded Sunshine Station. Early works had begun on the project in 2022, before delays, with the opening date of the line significantly pushed back due to these delays. Sydney Metro, estimated cost $20 billion. The Sydney Metro is Australia's biggest transport project. Expanding the already existing Metro Northwest line, the construction project includes City and South West Line, the West Line, and the Western Sydney Airport Line. The City and South West Line will be a 30 kilometre extension from the end of the Northwest Line at Chatswood under the Sydney Harbour through the new CBD stations and southwest to Bankstown, and is due to open in 2024. The West Line involves a 24 kilometre line doubling the rail capacity between Greater Parramatta and the CBD, which will link new communities to rail services and aims to support employment growth and housing supply. And the Western Sydney Airport line will service the previously mentioned new Western Sydney International Airport and aims to commence services at the same time as passenger airline services start. This massive project, once complete, will see Sydney Metro having built and then operating a network of 46 stations, 4 metro lines, and 133 kilometres of new rail. It will have a target capacity of 40,000 customers per hour, a huge increase from current 24,000 people an hour. It will revolutionise how Australia's biggest city travels with fast, reliable, turn-up-and-go services with fully accessible stations. So there you have it, some of Australia's massive infrastructure projects currently under construction. These projects are shaping the future of the nation, and the investment made today will undoubtedly leave a lasting impact for generations to come. Will any of these projects affect you in your day-to-day life? Do you think they're going to have a positive or negative effect on your community? Please let me know in the comments and tell me what part of Australia you think needs upgrading, updating, or uplifting. We've looked at a lot of massive construction projects today, but in Brisbane, there are plenty of game-changing projects that will completely alter the way you live and visit the city. Check out this video here so you can find out exactly how. That's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been talking tactics.